I can't lie to you, Erica. I am married.
Children?
Two. But they're hardly children any longer. I'm sorry.
For what?
I didn't mean to keep it a secret. It doesn't have to interfere with our relationship, does it?
I wasn't aware we were having a relationship.
Mr. Reynolds?
Yes?
Is Miss White in today?
Yes, she's in the building somewhere, working, which is more than I can say for you.
Is that the bird that owes you?
Yeah, just wait till she shows her face.
I wonder where he is.
Maybe taking a sickie.
Yeah. Oh, bugger.
Morning, Doreen. How are you today?
Paul, what are you doing here?
Sorry to bother you so early, Meg, but I don't suppose Tony's been in touch with you, has he?
Well, yes, he was here last night.
What for? I mean, what did he want?
Oh, I think he just needed someone to talk to, someone not quite so closely involved with his problems.
When did he leave?
About 8, I suppose. Well, Paul, what's all this about?
His bed hadn't been slept in. Some of his clothes have gone. I know I shouldn't be worrying about him, but damn it all, I am.
Hey, sunshine.
You talking to me?
Yeah. Why don't you lash out and buy me a machine that works?
What's wrong with it?
It's all loose and thinny down here.
Yeah, increase the tension on top there.
Why don't you fix it?
Fix it yourself. How you going, Doreen?
All right, thank you.
Any problems with your machine?
No, it's in real good nick, thanks.
Keep up the good work.
You're giving you trouble, honey. You okay?
Sure, she's okay.
It's all over her. She's got it made.
Sure. Here's your machine, Doreen.
There you go. She struck it lucky.
Lucky? He gives me the creeps.
Is Mrs. Davidson in yet?
No, no one's in. Not even the receptionist. Were you two out on the town? Our social worker doesn't seem very sociable this morning.
Oh, he's got a lot on his mind, Joyce. Has Mrs. Davidson rung to say when she'll be
here? No, not yet.
Well, what's the staff position then?
Well, Vera's not here because she was on duty last night. Jim's at the factory, so that leaves guess who in charge?
Looks like a job for Super Meg.
So you can start by censoring these letters.
B. Smith. I can't remember when she last got a letter. Well, here's one for Judith Bryant. It's unusual. Oh, and Doreen, of course.
Oh, that'll be her husband. Do you know he writes to her nearly every day?
Hate reading love letters.
Good morning, Wentworth Detention Centre.
Come on, Gladys, here's your chance to get your money back.
No.
I'll give you 10 to 1.
No.
What about you, Irene?
No. Who wants to bet with a bookie that Welsh is?
I'm gonna pay.
You still owe us for last time. You want us to hold our breath till that Kay White mole pays up?
She'll cough up.
Pigs might fly. You got Buckley's for getting it out of her.
She'd better come good.
What are you gonna do if she doesn't? Dob her into the screws?
Hey, Fletch.
What do you want?
I need to shift some stuff in the storeroom. Can I use one of your girls?
Well, as long as you don't take all day.
10 minutes should do it. Yeah, this one'll do.
Doreen, Vince needs a bit of a hand in the storeroom.
Yeah, I got a few bolts of cloth got to move.
Well, come on, hop to it.
Hey, how about me? You know, I'm used to heavy work.
Are you volunteering, Bryant?
Yeah, well, I could use the break.
No, look, this one'll do.
No, use Bryant. She seems keen enough.
All right, if you're so bloody anxious.
There you go.
Is that it then, eh?
Yeah, you can cart that lot back.
You know, it's a pity you didn't have Doreen to help you.
No skin off my nose. Which one of you helped me? You, Doreen, any of those slags out there?
You don't fancy any of us, eh?
I'm not that hard up.
Mm. Well, that's good, you know. Because it'd be tough on a girl if you fancied her and she didn't fancy you. I mean, who'd ever take the word of a criminal against a fine, upstanding citizen like yourself?
That's sort of a lie. Could only get her into trouble.
Yeah, I know. She'd even lose her work release.
I'm glad you realize that.
Oh, I realize that. I'm not stupid. You know something? I must be stupid. Because I wouldn't care about my work release. If you touched anyone, I would just speak up loud and clear. Now, how does that grab you?
What's that got to do with me? Haven't been any complaints, have there?
Not yet.
Somebody must be all thumbs around here.
Yeah, you just can't get any decent help these days.
Perhaps we're making her nervous.
Can't imagine why. Everyone knows how we feel about baby bashes. Know how you told me what she was like when she came in? Butter wouldn't melt in her mouth. Just dying to see her kids again.
Yeah. So she could have another go at them. Yeah.
Oh, stop it!
Oh, hear that, Lizzie? She wants us to stop it.
Stop it? Stop what? I ain't done nothing. I just made a remark. Not as though I'd done anything real bad.
Yeah, not like assault and battery on a three-year-old kid.
Oh, stop it! Just stop it!
No, that's what the kid said too. Stop it, Mummy! Stop it!
Oh, just get it over with. I know you're gonna bash me. Just get it over with.
Hey, Lizzie, she's asking for it.
You don't have to tell me what I did. I know what I did. He was so little. And I hit him. He wouldn't stop crying. Oh, why do you have to punish me? I've lost my kids. Can't you understand?
Sure. Righto, what's going on? Summers, what's wrong with you?
Oh, pangs of remorse, Mrs. Barry. Shame you missed it. It was as good as a play.
Oh, you just don't understand. I'm worried sick about my kids. Oh, where are they? Who's looking after them?
Whoever it is, they have got to be better than you.
That is enough, Smith.
Tim won't look after him.
Mr. Reed, the social worker, will know what arrangements have been made.
Can I see him?
Well, no, not now. He's out.
They could be home by themselves.
Well, you can see Mr. Reed when he's back. But you must behave yourself. Now, no more noise. And you lot, get back to work.
She sounded fair dinkum, B.
Like I said, as good as a play.
Door. Oh, so take the... Oh, that one there, good. Thanks.
What happened? Was he cross?
He won't be bothering anyone anymore.
He didn't say I dobbed him in.
Well, of course not. I just told him he'd got to keep his nose clean, that's all.
He'll know you meant me.
Listen, don't be so feeble. It's about time that you stood up to creeps like him.
It's all right for you, Judy. You haven't got anything that he's after.
It's just as well, isn't it? Where did all this stuff come from? Does Vince know all this is in here? Yeah, he just had me bring it back from the storeroom. I'd like Vince to release so much at the one time.
You mean it could get pinched?
What's the matter, Margo? You sound upset.
Yeah, I'm $150 worth of upset.
I'm sorry about that. I meant to get to the bank this morning.
Slipped your mind, huh?
No, I just haven't had time, that's all.
Listen, I got a problem. I can't pay them until you pay me.
I'm good for 150. I'm good for 1,000.
Maybe, but you're not so good for my betting business. I'll have to pack it in if I don't get that cash, so I bloody well want it today.
Don't take that attitude with me. You're in no position to threaten anyone.
Oh, Pete, you haven't seen Tony lately, have you? No, oh, well, as late as last night, to be precise. Oh. No, nothing's wrong. Thanks, mate. Come in.
Gail Summers?
Oh, yes, Gail, sit down, please. I hear that you're worried about your children.
Yeah.
Well, that's understandable.
Well, where are they? Who's looking after them?
I thought they were with your mother-in-law.
She can't look after them. She can hardly even look after herself. Oh.
Well, you can be sure they're not being neglected. Your husband wouldn't risk that if he's going to apply for custody.
Well, he won't get them, will he?
That depends on how your case is presented.
I haven't got a case. Put my own boy in hospital.
Anyone who's met your husband would realize that there are mitigating circumstances.
No. There's no excuse for what I did.
Look, Gail, you were pushed too far, and Mrs. Jackson will testify to that in court. She'll probably be called as a witness by your solicitor.
Solicitor?
Yes, you do have legal representation, don't you?
I can't pay for a solicitor.
But haven't you heard of legal aid?
Obviously not. I'll get someone from legal aid to come out and talk to you tomorrow. They'll tell you everything.
But I can't afford it.
Gail, it's free. Or rather, you pay according to your means.
Don't see how anyone can help me. Who'd want to leave a kid with me again?
Gail, we all have our breaking point. Fortunately, most of us are never, ever pushed quite that far. But there are hundreds of mothers out there who are terrified that they will kill their child. Yet help is available. And we can do something for you.
Think I'll have another cuppa.
It's not your day, Margo.
I've got time for a quickie.
Yeah, as Vince said to Doreen.
Will you cut that out? You're only going to get her into trouble.
All right, you women, get back to work. Oh, come on, you haven't got all day. Here, just a minute. What have you been saying to Bryant?
Nothing.
She tried to heavy me in the storeroom. You spilled the beans, haven't you?
I didn't say anything.
How did she find out, then?
Well, I don't know. She must have guessed. I didn't tell her about us.
Oh, no, just a minute. It's not us if this is a fan, sweetheart. It's you, trying to blackmail honest working man. Get it?
Yes.
Right. Keep your trap shut in future. Go on, get back to work.
Yeah, well, if you do see him, will you get him to ring his old man?
Sorry, did I interrupt something?
Oh, no, I'm just still trying to locate Tony. What's the problem, Meg?
Oh, it's about Judy Bryant. There's a letter waiting for her. I sent it this morning.
Not bad news.
Is it ever good? Mm. It's about her father. He's very ill, not expected to live. He wants to see her.
There's not much chance of that, is there? Were they very close?
It's hard to tell. The letter was from her sister. They weren't close, that's for sure. Disapproval dripping from every line. Mm.
So, I suppose you want me to talk to Judy?
Well, not talk as much as listen. I mean, she'll need to bend somebody's ear.
Mm. I sometimes wonder if I picked the right trade. Man can't even look after his own son, and here he is setting up as a Mr. Fix-It for everybody else. It's ridiculous, isn't it?
Look, Tony will be in touch when it suits him, Paul. He's young, strong and fit. Look, perhaps he went to Sydney to see Sally.
I would hope not. That woman is nothing but trouble.
But he was fond of her.
Yes, fond enough to break his good behaviour bond. No, he might be young, strong and fit, but he's a bit short on common sense at the moment. I'll go and have a talk to Sally's mother. Maybe she knows where she is. I'll talk to Judy when I get back from the factory.
Well, thanks, Paul. Yes?
I'm Paul Reed, Tony's father.
Yes, Sally mentioned you. You're a social worker, aren't you?
That's right, Mrs. Blakely. I was wondering if you know where Sally is right now.
Why do you want to know?
Well, Tony might be with her. He seems to have left home.
Well, he wouldn't be with Sally. She went off to Sydney with Bill Perry. Oh, he's the one who got her into trouble. He wouldn't be with them.
I see. Well, he may have gone looking for her.
Look, I do worry about Sally. If he does find her, would you let me know?
If I learn anything, I'll be in touch.
I'm sure he'll be all right. He's a much more sensible child than Sally ever was. You're very lucky to have a boy like that, Mr. Reed.
Mouse. Ah, here you are, Lizzie.
Oh, ta, Mrs. Jackson. It's from Marcia. Look, doesn't she write lovely?
It's one for you, B.
That's one for the books.
Oh, is there one there for me, Mrs. Jackson? There should be, thanks.
Oh, send her, Mr. Ken Pierce. I'll toss your foot. No need to get shirty.
Lorna? Judith Bryant? Sorry, ladies, that's all.
What do you say, love? I'll read your own, Lizzie.
Oh, no, I'm saving this till after tea. That's something to look forward to. Go on. What's he saying, Ralph?
Oh, well, he says that they're cutting down where he works and he's only got deliveries 3 days a week now. He could really do with that factory contract.
Well, you can't do anything about that.
Oh, I don't know.
You heard what Davo said. You got to stop trying to swing things for Kev.
Yeah, but if Kevin knew what the lowest tender was, he could undercut it, no worries. All I have to do is find out what the lowest bid is.
You could get into awful trouble.
Only if Davo finds out.
Both got a letter, huh?
Yeah, I nearly dropped out of the shock.
Yeah.
Good news.
Oh, Mum was all right.
Not forgotten, huh?
Well, not yet anyway.
Well, neither am I, so it seems.
Except from your family.
My sister. She finally decided to write to me after 20 years. I'm sure the strain nearly broke her arm. Still, I guess she had to write to me. Dad's got cancer.
Oh, gee, I'm sorry. Still, you never know. They fight that off for years sometimes.
No. He'll be dead before I get out of here. You know, he wants me to come home. He didn't want me to come home 20 years ago, did he?
Why? What happened?
Oh, well, someone I was in love with killed herself. Oh. They all said it was my fault. Well, it couldn't have been theirs, could it? They just caused her to lose her job, her self-respect, everything that held her together. All I ever did was love her. Anyway, that's when I packed it up and came here.
Didn't anyone stick by you?
Well, my family certainly didn't. I think sometimes Dad wanted to, but he just made noises about it. He didn't have the guts to stand up to the rest of the family. Families. Who needs them?
I believe you've had a letter from your family. I'm sorry to hear about your father.
Word gets around fast.
Mrs. Jackson censored the letter. And we both feel that it's very rough on you. If he'd been a local, you would have been allowed to visit him.
Yeah. I suppose you would have even let me go to the funeral, huh?
Yes, that could have been arranged.
That's crazy. You wouldn't let me go to Sharon's funeral, but some old man I haven't even seen for 20 years.
Is that all he is to you?
As far as I'm concerned, he died a long time ago.
Why are you so bitter towards your father, Judy?
Well, I suppose he can't help the way he is, huh? You know, that's crazy. That's what he used to say about me. Oh, she can't help the way she is. You know, the rest of the family, they thought I'd turn dyke just to spite him.
He must have cared for you.
Yeah, well, I suppose he did in his own way.
Why don't you write to him?
No. He turned his back on me. He let the others force me out of town.
You said yourself he can't help what he is. Don't you think he's suffered enough?
Well, what's the point? He just wants his baby back. Baby? Baby elephant? Look, I'm just a middle-aged criminal with a pacemaker.
Well, write to him anyway.
Well, what would I say?
You know what he wants to hear.
Yeah. I forgive you, that sort of stuff, huh?
Come on, Judy. You know what he wants to hear.
Yeah, I guess I do.
Hey, watch it, kids! Watch it! Katrina! Katrina! Katrina!
Fiona! No, it's all right. Don't be scared. I'm the lady next door, remember? You shouldn't run on the road. You'll get hurt. Who's looking after you, eh? Come on. I'll take you inside. From next door. I just brought Katrina back.
Oh. I'm Pam. I just went down to get some seats. Where was she?
Nearly under a car.
Oh, well, you can't keep your eye on them all the time, can you?
You let her play downstairs.
Well, I've got to play somewhere. There are no backyards around here. Come on, get up, you little devil. Go and wash your face. Your father will be home soon. Go on in.
I thought Mr. Summer's mother was supposed to be looking after them.
Oh, old Elsie. Well, that's a laugh.
Well, who is in charge?
Oh, I am. I'm looking after the whole family, Dad included.
Well, you're here all the time.
Well, Tim asked me to do the job, so I thought I'd give it a go.
Oh, you're living here then?
Well, I'm not living in the car park.
Well, if you need any help...
Oh, no, thanks. I don't need any help.
Well, if you do, I'm next door.
It's all right. I can manage this lot. No worries.
Porch.
The screws catch you with that, Lizzie. We'll all be for it.
You'd think she'd have memorised it by now.
Oh, good. If she hasn't, I have. Dear Grandma, tomorrow I go to hospital to get fixed up. Thank you for making it all come true.
And I wouldn't swap you for any other grandma in the whole world.
I'm fed up with you two. At least I shared my letter.
I shared mine?
Yeah, but Bea didn't.
Yeah, what did Ken say, Bea?
None of your business.
See what I mean? Plain bloody selfish.
You gonna write back to him?
Oh, I don't know. I can't write letters.
Yeah, but you could write to him.
I need to show myself up. He writes like he went to uni. You know how old I was when I left school? 15.
You gotta write to him, B. He'll be expecting to hear.
Yeah, just write like you talk. It'll come out okay, B.
Oh, what's the use? I could write my guts out, and he'd still be out there. No, I'd still be in here.
Frankie, we just went out and hopped over the wall. Lizzie was going to come with us, but her heart gave out.
Couldn't do it now. You'd have Buckley's.
Yeah, you'd blown it for everybody else.
I did not. Ros got away.
Yeah, she didn't get far, did she?
Well, that wasn't my fault.
Didn't Bea have a go once?
Oh, yeah, that was when she landed up in hospital. And she reckoned seeing that she was halfway out, she may as well go all the way.
Hey, look at Judy. Come on, wake up, America.
I was just wondering about the bolts of cloth. There seem to be two missing.
Put them back, Noeline.
It's not funny, you know. We're liable to get blamed for it.
Oh, I wouldn't worry. Vince has probably taken them. Anyway, you had more than you needed.
Yeah, I guess so.
Miss White, I was wondering, has Mr. Reynolds got a new delivery firm yet?
What's it to you, Dory?
Oh, it was my husband. You see, he could do with the job, and he's real good. Honest, he is.
Honest, he'd have to be.
Oh, Kevin's clean. He hasn't been in any trouble. You'd only have to meet him to see what a real good bloke he is. And you could really do with the work.
Well, the delivery contract is still up for grabs. I think Mr. Reynolds is deciding tomorrow. Vince is handling the tenders.
Oh, isn't there anyone else?
No. Mr. Reynolds always leaves that kind of thing to Vince.
Sleepless night?
I managed to doze off about 3 o'clock.
Take it Tony isn't back?
No.
Well, I still say he can look after himself, Paul. He's not as dim as you think
he is.
It's
not a question of Tony being dim. It's me. I'm disappointed. I thought we were getting along so well together.
Well, when I talked to him, I got the distinct impression that he'd learnt from his mistakes.
Well, let's hope so. You want some coffee?
Oh, no, thanks. Look, I'm here to report on the Summers kids. They're back at the flat.
Oh, well, I wish I'd known that before I tangled with Granny. I could hardly get away from her. Are the kids okay?
No.
There's a close friend of Tim Summers in charge, a Pam somebody.
How close a friend?
Very close, I gather. Because in every other department, she is woefully lacking. Miss Incompetent of 1980.
And the problem is, what are we going to tell Gail?
Look, I just don't think she could handle the truth.
Well, I think we can keep some of the more depressing details away from her. Look, I've arranged for a solicitor to come and talk to her about the interim custody of the children.
Do you think they're likely to let her have them back?
Oh, no, not in the present state, but with this Pam lady's inadvertent help, we might be able to prize them away from Tim.
Yes, but that doesn't help Gail.
Look, she'll get help. Don't worry about that.
I need a hand in the storeroom.
Yeah, all right, help yourself.
The curse of Noeline on the machine.
All right, quiet you lot, it's like a hen house in here.
Oh, guess who thinks he's Colonel Sanders?
Right, I need someone to give me a hand in the storeroom. Don't all rush me at once, will you? No. Yeah, right, you'll do. I'll back to work, everybody.
Oh, I'll do it.
Bart out, I didn't ask for you.
He asked for me, Jude.
Go on, let's go.
Are you sure, honey?
Yeah.
Wacko, the storeroom, eh? Looks like that's where the action is.
Will you shut up? Doreen has no choice.
Didn't look to me like he twisted her arm.
Taking bets for the 2:15 at Randwick?
Maybe.
Well, I'll have $20 on razzmatazz.
Only when I see your money.
You can put it on the slate.
The slate is full up. You're $150 down, remember? You pay what you owe first.
And just how are you going to make me?
You bitch.
Don't you call me names or I'll slap you across the room.
Yeah?
Don't risk it, Margo. Anything you do to me is assault, remember? Anything I do to you is self-defense. Understand?
There now. That's what I like to see in a girl. A bit of common sense. What made you change your mind?
Oh, I thought I might as well.
Is that all?
Oh, well, all the girls started telling me what a beaut sort they thought you were, and it got me to thinking.
Yeah, well, you treat me right, and you won't regret it. Liked it last time, did you?
Yeah. How long have you worked here?
3 years.
Hmm. Gee, you must be real clever to get where you are in 3 years.
You put me on?
No, honest. I heard that you handle all the contracts here.
So what?
Well, you'd be handling the bids for the cartage contract, wouldn't you?
I might.
What would the lowest bid be, do you think?
What? Come on, I didn't come here to talk about cartage tenders, but you obviously did.
Oh, well, you see, it's my sister, and she's got 6 kids, and her bloke's out of work.
And he just happens to be an owner-driver.
Yeah, and he'll lose the van if he doesn't get something soon.
Yeah, well, if I tell you, will I get something soon? And I mean soon, we've only got a few minutes.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, well, the lowest tender so far is $300. Now, what are you going to give me?
Have you seen the kids, Mr. Reed?
No, I haven't, Gail, but Mrs. Jackson's seen them. Your husband's got a woman in to take care of them.
Who?
Gail, the children are fine. Now, sit down. Your solicitor's here. Bring them in, please.
How long's all this going to take?
Well, the courts won't rush things in a custody case. They'll take a close look at the track records of both parties involved before making a decision.
Particularly when the future of 3 children is at stake. How old are they, Mrs. Summers?
Gail, this is Mr. Robards, your solicitor. You do everything he tells you, and you'll be fine.
Katrina's 5, and Jason's 3, and the baby's just a year.
The husband is claiming custody.
Yes.
He must have a pretty good case, then. What makes him so confident? Well, I know about the child assault. Is there anything else?
Yes, he's claiming chronic instability.
How long have you been married, Mrs. Somers?
This time or last time?
You were married before. What happened then?
Just didn't work out.
Two failed marriages, that isn't good. What went wrong? Were you, didn't you like being tied down?
No, it wasn't bad.
Were you bored with the housework?
No, I like a clean house.
Would you rather have been out drinking with the girls?
No, look, I'm not a boozer.
You mean you weren't drunk when you attacked young Jason?
Look, I don't want him for a lawyer. He's not going to help me.
Gail, you could face worse than that at the hearing. They're out to prove that you're an unfit mother.
Yeah, and so's he.
No, he's not. In 30 seconds, he's established that you're not a drunkard and that you don't neglect your home. Now, please sit down and believe me, he knows what he's doing.
But they asked me about Jason. I won't know what to say. I heard him.
Mrs. Summers, the magistrate knows his arithmetic. 3 sick children, 5 and under, in a small flat.
How do you know they get sick?
At that age, there's always one down with something, especially when the mother is short of money to feed and clothe them adequately.
Yeah, well, Tim always spent more on beer than he did on us.
Did he help you with the children?
It's hardly ever home.
On the other hand, you were never out of the house. What happened to young Jason was almost inevitable, Gail. May I call you Gail? It's an established pattern in our community, child abuse. Everybody expects a young, inexperienced girl to be a good mother, but nobody bothers to train her. When she does lash out at the child, it's the ultimate crime. So bad, she won't even admit it to herself. But if she doesn't get help, next time she could really hurt the child.
I don't see where the help had come from.
There is help to be had. Parents Anonymous is one group. You just ring them when the pressure's building up.
Yeah, and they send in the police.
No. They listen. They advise. They take the pressure off. Now, to get back to the matter in hand, do you really want to keep your children?
Yeah, of course I do.
Good. Then buck up, and we'll give that husband of yours a run for his money.
You all right? It took a long time.
I had a cigarette.
He didn't try anything, did he?
Oh, look, just lay off me, will you? I'm all right.
All right, little Miss Panic Merchant, there's your money.
Where's the rest?
You'll get it. Now do I get $20 on razzmatazz?
You only do your dough. Only bookies get rich.
Only when I see the other 20.
Oh. There.
If you really want to make some money, you should find that cloth that's gone missing and flog it.
Are you saying I stole those bolts of cloth? Are you accusing me, you thieving slut? Just because you've got sticky fingers doesn't mean we're all tired with the same brush. Excuse me.
Jeez. Can't even open your mouth around here.
Handspan, 5-1. Don't muck about with the ticket, because I can remember what I put.
Miss Bennett, can I have my phone call now?
What do you mean, your phone call?
We're allowed one a week.
You can have it in the morning.
Oh, I've got to have it now. Mrs. Davidson said it was all right for me to ring Kevin during rec time.
I'll ask the governor, but don't be surprised if she says no.
You know, we're going to have to get another player. I mean, three-handed poker is about as much good as a three-legged horse. How about you, B?
No, thanks. I'm not interested.
Mrs. Davidson?
Yes?
It's Doreen Burns.
What's wrong now?
Well, she insists she's entitled to a phone call.
Well, can't this wait till the morning?
I'd be very happy for it to wait till the morning, but she claims you gave her permission to make the call now.
Well, she hasn't had a phone call this week yet, has she?
Well, that isn't the point, is it?
Miss Bennett, if there is a point, I wish you would come to it.
Well, we all know she was trying to get Kevin Burns a job at Reynolds. Now, if she'd succeeded, she could have put the whole work release in jeopardy. Do you think she should be allowed to communicate with him under the circumstances?
Miss Bennett, we can hardly begrudge the girl a call to her husband.
If you'll excuse me for saying so, I don't think we should indulge her.
She can take the call in Paul Reed's office. Don't worry. She's been read the riot act. She won't try anything.
Aren't you going to supervise the call?
I'm sure I can leave that to you. Good night, Miss Bennett.
Mrs. Davidson said she could make a phone call. Is that convenient? Get on with it, Burns.
Here you go.
I don't know what Mrs. Davidson's thinking of, letting me make phone calls at all hours of the day and night.
Kevin? Oh, gee, it's nice to hear your voice. Yeah, I missed you too, love.
Hurry up, Burns.
Look, I can't talk now because Miss Bennett's breathing down my neck, but the lowest tender for the cartage contract is $300.
She can't do that. Get the phone from her.
So, if you put in one for $280 and you get round the first thing in the morning, you should get it. Got to go now, love. Bye.
You're going straight to solitary. The governor can deal with you tomorrow. I told Mrs. Davidson she'd take advantage, but would she listen?
Well, you're always so right, Miss Bennett. I'm surprised we don't take notice of you more often.
Good night, Mr. Reed, and thanks for the phone call.
I get out of here. Go on. Dear Ken, it was really great to get your letter. It's the first real letter I've ever had in here. I didn't expect to be remembered, but I must say I rather like it. It sounded so much like you too. Straight from the shoulder, and no bulldust. You're really going to have to forgive this note. I'm a bit out of practice after all these years. And I always did write like a camel waltzes. Nothing's changed. Well, it never does in here. But then why am I telling you that? I think I hate the winter most of all.
Thank God for the laundry. At least it's warm.
Hey, why don't you use the trolley?
No, oh, it's too much trouble.
You're really giving that pacemaker of yours a workout, aren't you?
She's loony. She's toting bolts of cloth around the factory as though she had a proper heart.
You know what she thinks? She thinks that just when they put the pacemaker in, they took me heart out.
What do they do then?
They just put in a little machine, you know, and when your heart starts to slow down, it moves it along.
Does that mean you're bionic?
Only on Thursdays.
Like I said, you can't trust the likes of Doreen Burns.
If you have bad news, Miss Bennett, you can wait until I get to my office.
Yes, but she's in solitary.
I see. What happened?
She did exactly what she was warned about. Under my very nose, she told that husband of hers the lowest cartage tender at the factory. She'll get him in there yet.
Miss Knox, would you get Burns out of solitary and into the laundry?
I would have thought you'd kept her there at least a week.
Doreen is not a bad girl. I'll admit that in the past few weeks she's caused us more trouble than most of our hard cases. But that only means that something is wrong somewhere. I'm not prepared to come down heavily until I know what it is. Nor will I allow her current shenanigans to interfere with the factory project.
Sally, call for an ambulance. Tell them it's urgent.
What's happened?
Bryant's just collapsed in the laundry.
She's not faking?
Not as far as I can tell.
You sure she's not having you on?
Well, her colour's bad, her pulse is feeble, and she's fighting for breath. What more do you want?
Birdsworth can produce all those symptoms at will, and she's hale and hearty.
I could let her die to convince you, Miss Bennett, but I would prefer not to oblige.
Well, the scars healed rather nicely, even if I do say so myself. You don't get trouble with a new pacemaker, not these days. What have you been doing? Running full tilt at a brick wall?
I just went crazy, that's all.
Well, it seems to be functioning normally again,
even if you aren't. Have you been anywhere near a microwave oven?
Oh, you don't think they'd have that sort of thing at Wentworth, do you?
Well, where were you working when it happened?
In the laundry.
Well, it could be some electrical interference.
Oh, it's never affected me before.
We'll take you down to cardiology for further tests, but I don't think they'll show anything.
How long are you going to keep me in here?
Well, we'll keep you overnight, but you should be fit enough by tomorrow.
Tomorrow, huh?
Think it'd hurt you either, Jace. Come on, let's go run a bath. Come on. Look, we'll have to come into my place to run a bath, eh? At least it won't be full of dirty nappies.
What the hell are you doing here?
Jace, you go and find Teddy and we'll give him a bath too, eh?
I know who you are. You're that busybody from next door, always interfering, Tim says. Well, you can stop putting your oar in right now.
I came in because I smelt something burning.
Oh, yeah, you couldn't wait to get over here and show me up, could you?
It's a bit early to be on the grog, isn't it? How long have you been away?
What's it to you?
Look, you left the stove on with hot porridge and milk on it and handles where Jason can reach them.
Yeah, big deal.
You could have burnt the flat down with everybody and everything in it.
Oh, yeah, and pigs might bloody fly, too. Listen, mate, I'm not one of your crims. You can't boss me around. Just why don't you just get out of here and leave me and the kids alone?
Kids? They're not your kids. And God help any you might have.
Oh, get out of here. Go on, you nosy bitch. Just get out of here.
Right now, that's you all wired up. Very soon, we'll see if we can get this machine working. You feeling comfortable?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Good. I don't think anything will show up. My bet is that you've had some electrical interference from some sort of machine.
Well, I was near the dryers in the laundry.
Well, it sounds as though I'll have to have another word with the prison authorities. Can't have my patients being knocked around like this, can I?
Don't worry, Doctor. It won't happen again.
Excuse me, Doctor. Do you mind looking after things here for me? I've got to go out for a moment.
Of course, Officer. We're not going anywhere.
I won't be long.
Now then, let's see what we have here. Now, the normal electrocardiogram shows one wave corresponding to the activity of the atria and four waves corresponding to the phases of the ventricular beat. Now, in your case, with a pacemaker, the atria is bypassed. So, to all intents and purposes, yours is a perfectly normal ECG. Conclusion? There's nothing wrong with your pacemaker. Oh, damn. There's no getting away from these things, not even in the loo. Excuse me a moment, I won't be a second.
Hello?
Could you ask Dr. Morris to have a look at that? Oh, yes, of course. I forgot it was his morning for the clinic. Look, it doesn't sound too serious. Just keep an eye on her, and I'll be there as soon as possible, all right? Yes, well, I'm doing an ECG at the moment, so it shouldn't be too long. Yeah, right, thanks. Goodbye.
Yeah.